I think finally there's no way to be in the pulpit other than as yourself, the interpreter. I was very emboldened some years ago by something that Sam Wells said to me after it was the first time I had preached at Duke Chapel. I was quite nervous about my sermon. I had several lengthy quotations from Soren Kierkegaard in this sermon. And I asked Sam afterwards, what did you think of the sermon? And he said some very nice, I think true, complimentary things. And then he said, I just don't think that you needed the Kierkegaard. You could have said that in your own voice. What was being said in those quotations was not so specific to Kierkegaard that you needed to quote it. And I think that you were relying on his authority instead of trusting your own authority. And that has really been a powerful invitation to me since he said that some years ago, to say, why am I going to this other voice? And sometimes there's a good reason. But if there's not a good reason, if it's that I don't trust my own authority, then I try to listen to Sam inviting me further into the space of my own voice and authority. And I will always be grateful to him for that